Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Scribblings of Life. And on this channel I share a lot of videos on easy DIY crafts and various kind of art forms which you can learn easily by watching my videos, because my motive is to make beginners learn art forms. Okay, so in today's video we are going to create a mini fridge magnet on a mini canvas. So this is the design that we are going to create. So for that I have taken this canvas. This is a normal board canvas and it is of size 4 by 4 inch, I think, or maybe 3.5 by 3.5 inch, something like that. It is from canvasify.com and this is a very nice quality canvas. So basically what we have done over here is we have already primed this canvas using the gesso and dried it for few hours. Now to create the background we have to blend few colors. Okay, so here I have given the colors of sunset. So basically not me, these canvases were created by my husband. So he is doing this video and I am just giving the voiceover on this video. So to create the base we have taken few colors over here, and these are Camlin acrylic colors, tube form, and this is the white color which we are applying over here. Then we have taken a shade of orange, yellow and red. So you can now watch the video and understand the process how the blending has been done to get the desired effect. And this is a very easy process. You can try it very easily at your home. Even if you are not very well versed with the acrylic painting, you can easily create such backgrounds. So I hope you like this video and I will be coming back soon here. So enjoy watching it. So here the bases were ready. So I had made 8 of these fridge magnet for my mini Rakhi hampers this year, and I had used a stamp to like basically write this sentiment over here. I am using my Misty tool. This is my Tim Holtz stem set from which I have taken this sentiment over here, and using my VersaFine Onyx Black ink, which is a permanent ink, I am stamping this sentiment on this canvas. So since the canvas is not a smooth surface, it is a bit grainy, we have to stamp it 3-4 times to get a crisp image, okay? Like I have done at least 2 times here, okay? So now I am stamping it, and once the stamping will be done on all the canvases, we are going to dry it for some time and then we will varnish it to give the desired effect. So here you can see that it is not clear, right? So I am stamping it again. This is the benefit of having a stamping tool, that you don't have to worry that if you are using that acrylic stamping thing to stamp your image, you have to be very sure that you stamp correctly in a single time, otherwise it may, the image will not be crisp, it, because you cannot position it very accurately. But using a stamping tool, you can do it very accurately. So this is how I created these magnets, and let the stamping part be done, and then I will explain how I pasted the magnets on the back side of these canvases. So here are all my 8 canvases. Not I didn't show 8 here, but I had made 8. So these are the magnets which I bought from a local hardware shop, and using the Fevibond is basically a rubber synthetic glue. So we need to paste the magnets using this glue, and after applying the glue you can just paste it normally and it will stick. Just keep it untouched for some time and it will be stick properly. So this whole idea was of my husband's, and he executed it. I am just helping him creating the video and voiceover editing and all. So any magnets and watercolors thing, generally he do. So I hope you like this video and you will try something of similar notes. So you can share your creation on my website in the community tab. It's www.stepstowardscrafting.com, and if you like my videos, you can share it among your friends and family, and don't forget to hit the bell icon and subscribe button. Bye.